If there's a feature that I dread the most, it will be the hair. Most artists hate drawing the hair. But even though I'm not a fan of drawing the hair, I've learned a very weird technique to draw the hair and to draw it well. Coming up. So what makes this technique different from my previous technique is that I will be using a pen to draw the hair. Yes, I mean actual pen, biro, if you know what I'm talking about. And this is what makes it so weird. It's not every day that you see someone use an ink pen to make a pencil drawing. But the hack here is to exhaust the ink in the pen. We want the pen to be free of ink so that it is empty and you'll be able to create marks on the paper. It will take forever to try to remove all the ink from the pen. So just do what I did. If you can, remove the tip of the pen and connect it to the end of the pen. Then start writing on a crap piece of paper so that you can exhaust the ink. This will still take some time, so just a little heads up. When the pen is free of ink, start creating marks on the paper according to your reference photo. Trust me, you'll be surprised at what these marks will later turn out to be. But for now, just look at the lines in your reference photo and replicate those lines with the pen. Make sure not to also add too many lines. I did that and trust me, it did not turn out well. After adding the marks, start with the lightest pencil you can find. For me, I'm using an HB pencil, but you can also use a 2B or a B pencil. Sharpen the pencil and start replicating the lines that you created with the pen. As you can see, at this point, I haven't mapped out the highlights for the hair. All I'm just doing now is creating the lines. And after I create the lines, sometimes I blend, other times I don't. Now I'm not blending with this, I'm just going straight with, well, of course, you guessed it. I'm going straight with my charcoal pencil. And as you guys know, I'm intoxicated with using charcoal. But do keep in mind that you want to sharpen your charcoal pencil. Charcoal pencils can become very blunt quickly, so you want to sharpen them frequently. And just like I did with my HB pencil, I am creating lines that go in the direction of the hair. Right now, I'm shading with light pressure. But I'm also doing something differently. I am leaving a section for the highlights. One of the worst things that can happen is to shade over the highlights, and it will be very hard to get those highlights back after you have shaded them. If you are wondering, I'm using a 4B charcoal pencil for this. My 2B charcoal pencil is almost finished, so I'm just making do with what I have. I'm almost positive that I'll get this question. Can I use graphite to draw my hair? Yes, of course, you can use graphite. But then you'll ask, why am I using charcoal? You see, charcoal can get dark very fast, and this is something I really need when drawing hair. I want the hair to be dark as fast as possible. But if you've only got graphite pencil, by all means use that. I'm a big fan of using what you've got, making do with what is available. After that, grab a brush and blend those lines. As you can see, I am blending the lines in the direction of the hair, not just randomly. Remember also not to shade over the highlights. It will be very hard to get the highlights back after you have shaded over them. I made this mistake here, but it is also something we can fix later on. For the next step, I am still using my 4B charcoal pencil, but this time I am adding pressure. The first time I shaded with the 4B pencil, I did it with light pressure, but now I am adding more pressure to the pencil. And after that dose of charcoal, we are blending again with our brush. And don't feel obliged to use a brush, you can also use a blending stump, you can use a Q-tip. I'm not the kind of person that blends with fingers, so I would not advise you to use fingers to blend. But you can use virtually anything. But I like using a brush because with brush, you get smoother results. Right now, the hair looks good and I could just stop here. But let's take things to the next level and make it darker with our 6B pencil. And by that, I mean 6B charcoal pencil. And as you have noticed now, the whole process is basically rinse and repeat. We are just creating more lines, but only making it darker. And as you can see, we have also created the shine in the middle. But the shine is not shiny enough for me. So let's use our eraser and make some blinding lights. So I am simply using my kneaded eraser to create some eraser marks on the highlights. And now, will you look at that? It shines brighter than the sun. But now you'll be wondering, why on earth did I use a pen in the beginning anyway? But I want you guys to see something. Let me zoom in real close so that you can see clearly what I'm talking about. Do you see the small white marks and the small white lines that show up on the hair? These lines are there because of the pen marks that I created at the beginning. We see these professionals create amazing artworks and we're like, wow, see how much detail the hair has. But it's these crazy and stupid easy techniques like this that they apply to their drawings that makes it so realistic and have detail. These white marks aren't very bright, but it's enough to trick people to think that you actually created these marks with an eraser, but you actually used a pen. It was really fun making this. Do make sure to apply this next time you are drawing hair, because for me, this technique has come to stay. If you'd like to learn more about my weird and awkward techniques for drawing hair, do this. Check out the playlist on the screen now, and you'll be able to learn how I'm able to tackle different styles of hair step by step. So guys, watch that, and of course, I'll see you in the next one.